The following video was a Patreon request by Julia W. Yeah, another request. At this point, we might see the end of that backlog at around 2022 or so. It's sad that that's not even a joke. I really am putting out new reviews as fast as I can, guys, but I also want them to be good reviews, so it has to be within reason. The hand injury I mentioned in the Rebels review didn't help, though I'm mostly back to normal now. Anyway, today's request was for a movie called Windaria, which is another anime movie I haven't heard of. Par for the course for Julia's requests at this point. However, unlike most of the movies she's requested, this one is more on the classic side. Windaria, aka Fairy Tale War Windaria, is an anime movie from 1986, adapted from a novel by Keisuke Fujikawa, who was also the movie's screenwriter. Fujikawa had a pretty extensive background working on series like Ultraman and Space Battleship Yamato, and the movie was directed by Kunihiko Yuyama, who had previously worked on Magical Princess Mikimomo and Goshogun. And it was animated by Studio Gallup, who also worked on Kiki's Delivery Service, most of the Yu-Gi-Oh! Series, and one of my favorite underrated series, Kodocha. Unfortunately, Windaria had a bit of a problem when it came to how the series was localized in America. You see, it was brought over to the States by a company called Harmony Gold. And already, the classic anime fans in the audience are probably cringing. Okay, to be fair to Harmony Gold, if it weren't for them, we probably never would have seen certain anime in the US at all. But the problem with Harmony Gold is that they weren't afraid to chop up the anime they distributed, sometimes beyond recognition. It's because of them that Macross only got a release over here in the form of the mess that was Robotech, which was actually two shows smashed together. And to this day, they refuse to hand the rights over to someone else so we can even get a subtitled release of the original series. So yeah, to the people who love to complain about Funimation changing a line here or there, I want you to bear in mind that anime localization is the best that it's been in years. It could be a whole lot worse. Even Harmony Gold's director, Carl Masick, said that they weren't ever given a script or translation of the movie. So the way that most old-school anime fans experienced this movie back in the day was a chopped-up version with a happy ending, commonly known as Once Upon a Time. And if I know Julia's request, most of the movies she's asked me to look at decidedly do not have happy endings. Windaria has been re-released several times, but to this day the uncut Japanese version of the movie has never been officially released in this region. However, today we're going to be looking at what I think is a fan-sub Japanese version, but it was the most complete version of the movie I could find. Mostly because I don't like the idea of sitting through a Harmony Gold dub. Send that shit over to Another Dead Reviews. He seems to like weird chopped up dubs better than most old taku do. However, with that in mind, as complete as it can be, this is Windaria.